So in today's lecture, we'll be going to see what are lists. So what is a list? So in Python, there is a data type called list, and it is used to store the characters, or we can say some objects. Okay, so we can store list. We can use list for storing any anything, like we can store words, integers, or something like that, or sentences also. We can store sentences also in list. So list is basically a collection of objects. Like you have some collection of objects in your home. Okay, you just collect some cat, or we can say some coins. So that is also a collection. So the same way you can collect objects in Python also. So list is just a collection of objects. Okay. So list, how to basically declare a list. So list is basically declared using this square brackets. Okay, so if you are using square brackets, then basically it's a list. Okay, list can have zero elements, or we can say empty list also, or we can say or we can also have a list with one element, two elements, or and so on. Okay, so you can have an empty list also. So in this case, if I am basically not using any of these things, so that will be actually called as an empty list. Okay, so in this case, as you can see here, I have basically declared this as students. Okay, and it is Burness, Aaron, Cody. So whatever names I have just or I've just taken that names. Okay, and now what I'm here to doing here is that. So this is basically a list, and I'm using a for loop here to print my list. Okay, so basically what I'm doing here is that I'm basically using this for loop, like for student in student. Yeah, one second. Yeah, so basically I'm basically using here a for loop to iterate my list. Okay, so what it will do here is that for student and student, I'm basically using a print statement here, print hello. So this all of you know this thing, this is basically a string. Okay, because it's in double quotes, then plus student dot title plus this is also a string, exclamation mark. So why I'm basically using a student here. So student.title basically represents that it will be going through title wise. Okay, or we can say that what this for loop is actually doing here is that it is basically iterating this list. So whatever the elements are there in this list, like Burness, so in the first iteration you will take Burness and it will print this thing, hello Burness, and then this exclamation mark. Okay, then once again for loop will iterate to this this list. Okay, we will see the working of for loop also, that how actually for loop works, but for the time being you just see that we are basically iterating a list here. Okay, and we are just printing this thing, hello Burness, hello Aaron, hello Cody, whatever the students are there in this list. Okay, one by one. So this is the whole process of using this for loop with this list. Okay, now the second thing is that you can basically declare list in this fashion also. So when you are basically declaring a list, you have to just basically put all the elements in this double quotes. Okay, if it is a string, what if I want to store numbers. So for numbers also, I can basically use I can just basically print this thing, like one comma, and if I run this thing, so you will be seeing that I am basically using, and I'm printing this dots. So you can see here, so this border collie, it is basically a string, so this one is basically a number. Okay, so in this way you can store anything in your list, like integer, float value, numbers, or we can say the strings. Okay, now coming on to the next thing. So this is basically a list which I have called here, and I am basically just calling this list, or we can say calling the list in the elements wise. Okay, with element wise. Okay, so the indexing, what is indexing now? So indexing is basically what we can say, assigning some index value, or we can say the numbers, like you do in your columns, or we can say in your column charts, in the first page, or we can say the what we actually say that CSV to that the index page of your notebook. So in that index page you basically write one, then something, some heading, then two. So which are basically indexing your contents. So in the same way, list is also indexing that their elements. So the indexing of list basically starts from zero. Okay. So it is basically like this: 0, 1, 2, and so on. Okay. So this is the method of indexing in list. So whenever you're calling anything, like I'm basically using this thing, dog is equal to dogs, and in square bracket I've basically typed here 0. So 0 represents the first element of the list. Okay. So basically the counting here starts from 0. So that's why I basically use this thing. And then print dog dot title. So it is just yeah. So we can actually print the first letter, or we can say the first element of the list. If I change this thing to 2, so it will, you can see here, it is basically printing the last element, Labrador Retriever. Why? Because the index value for this Labrador Retriever is 2. Okay, like here you can see 0, 1, 2. If I print here 1, so it will give the middle value. Yeah. Okay. Got it. So in the same way, when you do this thing, one question. What if I'm basically supplying some other numbers here apart from the index? So we'll see how it is actually working. Suppose I have assigned 6 here. So it will give an error like list index out of range. Okay. So why this error is being thrown? Because there are no elements in the index 6. So that's why it is basically throwing some error.
मेरे को एक डाउट है सर, हेलो सर, यहाँ पे हम लोग 1 लिख रहे हैं तो ये पूरा लिखा पूरा आना चाहिए ना, ऑस्ट्रेलियन बैटल डॉग पूरा।
हाँ बताता हूँ व्हाई इट इज एक्चुअली नॉट हैपनिंग. द रीजन हियर इज दैट या इट्स कमिंग ना, व्हाई इट्स नॉट कमिंग, द ऑस्ट्रेलियन कैटल डॉग आ तो रहा है. यार वी कैन
पहले
सी.
नहीं आ रहा था।
ओह ओके वन सेकंड, लेट मी जस्ट, एक्चुअली वो टाइम पे फिर मैंने कुछ और किया रहेगा. वन सेकंड, आई एम प्रिंटिंग दिस थिंग.
हेलो
या इट्स वर्किंग प्रॉपरली. हाउ कम यू सीन दैट इट्स नॉट. या सो यू माइट हैव सीन सम अदर लिस्ट. ओके डोंट वरी. ओके सो दिस इज द होल प्रोसेस ऑफ यूजिंग इंडेक्सिंग. ओके नाउ अंडरस्टूड हाउ इंडेक्सिंग इज एक्चुअली वर्किंग. द सेम एग्जांपल आई वी आर बीइंग बेसिकली गिविंग हियर, लाइक डॉग्स डॉग्स वन, देन यू कैन प्रिंट दिस थिंग. ओके व्हाट इफ यू, या वन मोर थिंग, इन लिस्ट यू कैन डू नेगेटिव इंडेक्सिंग आल्सो. What do you mean by negative indexing now? Negative indexing means counting from backwards, or you can say from minus. Okay, so negative indexing starts from minus one. Okay, so as the positive indexing starts from zero, for negative indexing, it doesn't start from zero, then minus one, not like that. It is basically starting from minus one, minus two, minus three. Okay, so what if I am basically using this minus one here? So minus one, we will basically print the last element. So it will basically go to the last element, and then from here it will basically start the indexing, like minus one, minus two, minus three, and so on. Okay, so this is the process of negative indexing. And the same case here, minus two. So minus two is basically this thing, as I've told you. So you do the indexing in any form. If you want, you can use negative indexing. If you want, you can use positive indexing. You can use anything. Okay. And yeah, so this is the example which I've told you, that if what if we are using the numbers which are, we can say the index which are out of range, or we can say out of bound. So basically you can see here, there is some element which is having the index as minus 4. So it is giving me the error like this. Okay, like list index out of range. Okay, so this is the whole scenario for list. Now I have basically given some ex exercises here. Okay, so you can just type your code for these questions, and let's see if you are getting some answers properly for this thing. Okay, now coming on to the looping. So I'm basically going to tell you that how looping actually works in list. Okay, so you can basically loop your list. Okay, or we can say, and why looping? Because loops are actually that features in programming, because of which you can basically automate much of your task, or you can have more of your task, you can automate that thing. Suppose you want to count the number of rows in your data sheet, or in the Excel. So you basically want to see, you want to basically print all the rows, okay, from your data set. So in that case, if you use if you just see one row, then type it in the next table, or you can say you're noting down that thing. So it will not work. It will basically take more time. Okay. What if we can use for loop here? So for loop basically, it is basically used to iterate your list. So as you can see here, for dog in dogs, and then print dog. So what is dog is actually doing here? So this is basically a variable. Okay, you can use anything. Like I can use x also here, like this, and just print this thing. One second. Yeah. So basically, now as you can see here, if I'm doing this for x in dog, so what it will do here actually for x in dogs means. For so the x element is basically this thing. It will go into this x will go into this list and will check the first thing. Okay, in the first iteration, it will go to this first element, and it will just print that. Okay, so the value of x is getting equal to border collie for now in the first iteration. Then again, it will again run. Okay, or we can say it will again iterate. Then it will go to the next element and it will print that element. Okay, so in the line wise, you're getting this all elements. So this is the actual use of for loop. Okay, you can use your for loop. Suppose you want to print this line. Okay, suppose you want to print I like and all the dog names in different sentences, or we can say in separate sentences for every dogs. So what you will do, you will not just copy paste this thing, this dog's name, and just put it here and just go on. You can basically use for loops also. For loop will be basically will be doing your job in one go, okay, or in automatic way. So you just have to type this thing for dog in dogs, and then this dog will basically go to this list and will call out every element one by one, and it will print in this manner. Okay, so this is the actual use of for loop. And once this condition is getting satisfied, if the list is getting we can say exhausted, then this for loop will stop running and it will give you the final output. Okay, so this is the actual use of for loop. You can use it in any task. You'll get to know that how you can actually use for loops and how much important it is actually. Okay, then coming on to the second thing, this is the same example. I'm just basically using two print statements. I'm printing the two dog names here. Okay, you can say for this sentence also I'm printing one dog name, and for this sentence also. Okay, so you can use this thing also, and you can see here, so for every sentence you are getting this dog name like this. So it is basically getting you in iteration manner, as a line by line. Okay. Sorry, now coming on to the enumerating part. So what is enumerating a list? So when you basically loop the list, want to know the index of the index of a specific item, or you can say the current element. Okay, so you can basically use dot index value as a syntax for that case, and iterate your loop in simpler manner. Okay, so enumeration basically tracks the index of every element in the for loop. Okay, I'll show you the example. So suppose consider this is a list here. Okay, and you're just printing using a print statement. Result for the dog show are as follows. Okay, so I'm just placing all these dog names in a index wise. Okay, so what I'm here to do here is that I'm basically calling two variables, for index comma dogs. Okay, in enumerate dogs. So what this enumerate will do? Enumerate will go to this first element, and it will basically call out the index name also, or we can say the index value like 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, and in that manner, it will basically print all your things. Like I have just initialized a loop here. Then I basically use this place is equal to str.index. So what this place is, so str.index is basically, so this index is basically the value. So you can't see the index value like 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, but you can see the elements. So this index will iterate through the index value. Okay, index comma enumerate dogs. Enumerate is basically used to iterate through index also. Okay, so place str in bracket index. So index will basically store this index value like 0, 1, 2. And then you're basically printing this thing. So print plus place plus dog plus dog dot title. So dog is basically this variable, and you are printing in this for loop. So when you run this loop, you'll basically see that this index is basically getting enumerated as this value, index value 0, 1, 2, and at the same time it is basically iterating this part also, border collie also, okay, and then it will basically use this part. And basically you can see here that for every index value it is basically giving that dog's name, okay. So this is the whole scenario for enumerating the list, okay. Yeah, any doubts in this thing? Yeah.
Yes sir, ek aur baar matlab aap isko samjha do.
Yeah. Sure. So basically how you can actually use this for loop is that you can basically use different elements. Suppose if your data frame is having some different elements like one is index value, okay, 1, 2, 3, and for that every index value you have some values like dogs name, like border collie or string actor dog, something, okay. So basically in this scenario I want to iterate through index value also. So list is having some index value like 0, 1, 2, 3. So this is at 0's place, this is at 1's place, and it is at 2's place, okay. So I want to iterate that also. What I want to do here is that I want to print all the elements of the list with their index value. So that's how basically what I've done here is that I basically use this index for index comma dog. So index will iterate through index value like 0, 1, 2, 3. And this dog will iterate through the dog's name, like here, border collie and all those parts, okay. So for index comma dog in enumerate dogs. So enumerate is a function which is basically dealing with index value, because if you use this thing, if you remove this enumerate part here from here, so it will just iterate through this list, okay. It will not enumerate the list, or we can say enumeration is basically used to track of index, okay. So that's why basically I've used this enumerate part, and then in enumerate I've basically passed on my list, these dogs, okay. So now I want to store my index value in some variable, so I basically stored it in here, like place is equal to str index. I basically use this as a string for now, just to avoid errors, okay. Now I'm also using this part, like I've used this thing dog in enumerate, so dog will also get iterated for every iteration, okay. So for that thing I basically printed this value, this place, and this, and then this dog title. So what it will do in the first iteration, it will go to this first element, okay, and then it will just print the index value. What is the index value for this thing? 0, okay. So 0 aa jayega idhar, and then the value for this dog name, this index value is basically border collie, so ye bhi aa jayega idhar.
Yes sir, ho gaya, clear ho gaya,
samjha. So in this way it is actually running, okay. Yeah, okay, so we'll proceed further. So this is also the same thing. You can basically, if you want to change your index value, suppose in the real life scenario, anybody doesn't name their indexing from 0, okay, you just name it from chapter 1, chapter 2, something like that, okay. So in the same case here also, when you are iterating your list, you can basically add also. So this is the same code from the earlier part. I just want to change the place, okay. So place 1, place 2, place 3. So for that thing, I basically use this thing, index+1. So it will, in the first iteration, it will go to this list and it will basically print 0. So when it will come to this place here, so it will basically go and, so at first iteration, the value for index is 0, 0+1. Because we have basically used this +1 operator. So the for first iteration, it will give the value 1. Okay. And in the next iteration, it will go for once again go to this list. And for this this value, it is basically having the value 1. Okay. Now 1+1 to basically 2. So in this way, it is actually good. Okay. Understood this part?
Yes, sir.
Sir, agar jaise ye nahi likha hai 1, 2, hum log nahi the. तो हम लोग ऑटोमेटिक फर्स्ट वैल्यू को जीरो मानेंगे मतलब.
यस ये बेसिकली क्यों किया मैंने पता है क्या मेरे को क्या करना था मुझे बेसिकली किसी का प्लेस जीरो से चालू नहीं होता एवरीबॉडीज प्लेस स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 1, 2, 3 ओके इन रियल लाइफ ये तो कोडिंग है ओके सो फॉर दैट केस बेसिकली आई जस्ट यूज दिस थिंग index+1 सो दैट फॉर एवरी इटरेशन इट विल टेक दैट वैल्यू एंड इट विल +1 ओके सो दैट वी कैन हैव द प्रॉपर इंडेक्सिंग like if you have in our real scenario, because user wants this, okay. Okay, so moving on to the next part now. Yeah, So suppose what you can do here is that basically I have initialized this dogs is equal to this. Okay. Now for dog in dogs, print dogs. So what is the error here? Can you just tell me what is the error? Why it is actually? Because according to me, I use this for loop. Okay. And this for loop should be printing every single value of this list, but it is printing this whole list 3 times. Why it is doing here? Can you explain me?
सर ये फॉर डॉग लिखा है इसलिए
नो डॉग इज जस्ट एन एलिमेंट यू कैन यूज एक्स आल्सो हियर सपोज लेट्स टेक आई विल बी टेकिंग एक्स हियर नाउ हाउ इट इज वर्किंग मैं कुछ भी ले लूंगा उसमें ओके सो ठीक है ज्यादा सोचो मत आई विल जस्ट टेल यू द रियल एरर हियर ओके So basically, when you iterate your for loop, so basically, for every iteration, the value gets stored in this x, not in this dogs. Okay. So this dog is basically a list which is used for your iteration. It is not storing it. It is having that values. So if you print that same list here also, so it will basically what this for loop will see that yeah, I want to for every iteration I want to print this list. Okay, this whole list. So for that case, it is basically printing this thing. Like for first iteration, it is going here like this, and you are just printing this inside the for loop. You are basically having this print statement. So that's why 3 iteration hai, because there are 3 values here. Okay, so for every iteration, it is just printing this list. Okay, so that's why we are getting the list printed 3 times. Now, how can I solve this error? Just फॉर एक्स इन डॉग्स मीन्स एक्स इन दिस लिस्ट ओके सो ये एक्स है ना ये लिस्ट में जाएगा अंदर जाएगा ओके सो फर्स्ट इट विल चेक द फर्स्ट वैल्यू लाइक बॉर्डर कॉली then x will be getting equal to border collie then if you are printing x here so it will print this value like this okay then this x will go once again into this list and it will equate from for to this value and then it will print that value understood how it is actually working for loop so for loop ka main yes, is yes. here for loop main is this thing only you can do your counting part okay in a very precise manner you can't count up to 100 and then just write it down okay or if you're having any specific list and you want to write all the elements of that list in a single or you can say in a line by line you will not be just writing that list one by one okay you can use for loop for your counting purpose okay so this is the error which we have solved right now okay now coming on to the next thing So basically, in this example, I am basically using this dogs as a list, and for dog and dogs print, I like dogs plus this. So this is basically a string. This is also basically a string. What is this part? What is the error here now?
Sir, ये last वाली print में यहाँ पे dogs नहीं आएगा.
Yeah, what did you come here?
X.
नहीं x नहीं आएगा. So what the value will be dog here, not dogs. Okay, because here मैंने dog ले लिया. And what is the error here?
Sir, समझ गया.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Now इधर देखो error क्या है? Can only concatenate string, not list. Okay, so इससे क्या पता चलता है? We can't concatenate string list. Okay, we can't basically have some concatenation of list. Okay. Like list को list के साथ में concatenate कर सकते हो you can't concatenate a list with a string okay मतलब ये तुम ऐसा बोलोगे कि हाँ this is a list and I want to concatenate or we can say add up with this part no it doesn't happen here like that okay we'll see that thing also in the later part okay so for solving this part we can basically just remove this down and you can see the same thing which is happening okay okay So I think we should be doing this much for today. Okay. So what you guys can do here is that you can basically practice up to this part. Okay. And in the next lecture, I'll be just going through with this for loop. Okay. The next part. So this whole notebook is basically having three things: list, tuples, and sets. Okay. So first of all, I will be covering all the examples of list. Okay. So the next examples will be covered in the next lecture, which is tomorrow. Okay.